Hi, I'm Kevin Luckman, VP of Marketing at Nuaire Electronics. This is the first in a series of videos on how to acquire a low-cost single-board computer. Using these tips, you can save 10 to 15% on any industrial motherboard, and that's without paying an NRE or reducing the quality of the motherboard. The first of these tips is actually board level. Now, in the industrial market, we have our own little set of problems, separate from the consumer market. But we also have a lot of benefits as well. One of the main benefits is the leeway we're given in terms of product and in terms of customization. And that's where our first point comes in. Because in the industrial market, with industrial motherboards, you can actually take components off of the motherboard, customizing it, without paying any NRE, and you actually reduce the cost. Here's an example right here. Here's a board, the Commel LV671. And you can see it's got all the ports here, and if you take a look there, there's all the chips. Here is the same board, just customized a bit. Once again, no NRE. And just taking a look at it, you can obviously see there's something very different about it. And if you take a closer look, you'll see, okay, it's missing a parallel port, it's missing a serial port. It's missing a power connector, an SPDIF connector, and that's just talking about connectors. Flip this around so you can take a look at the chips. So here's the full board with everything on it. There's the full set of chips right here. There's some headers here as well. You take a look at this board and then you see that it's missing chips and headers. Right here, there should be some headers according to this board, but they're completely gone. And even down here, you can see the holes where the headers should be, but there they are on this board, and there they aren't are on this board. Now, that's just to give a visual example, but this customer in particular, by making all these changes, removing all these pieces, was able to save 10% on removing these components alone. So that's the first tip. It's a very valuable tip, unless you need everything, which usually it's not very common. The next tip is regarding the accessories. Every motherboard has its own set of accessories, and these are either priced on the price of the motherboard itself, or they're priced separately. The point is that it adds a cost. So you can take a look here, there's a whole bunch of accessories. You got SATA cables and just a whole mess of cables and accessories. And this does add a cost. And simply by taking out the accessories that you don't need, you can reduce the price some. And say you don't need any accessories at all. You leave out all the accessories, you can reduce the cost significantly. So those are the two tips that we're going to leave off with today. Using those two tips, they are very valuable. You can save a lot of money, especially if you're buying in large quantities. It translates to huge sums. And I hope this helped. This is the end of the first in a series. I look forward to seeing you next time.
This video was presented by NuAireElectronics.com. For more info on related topics, check out the NuAire blog.